everybody. My name is Matthew Joseph, the Director of Digital Learning and Innovation right here in the Milford Public Schools. And thank you for tuning in and viewing all of our MPS Talks. And continue tuning in because we have some great topics coming up. You heard one previously about digital citizenship. And today, I'm going to be talking about another phase in our role as educators, and it's about being leaders. There are countless articles about being a good school leader, but we also need to learn how to recognize and avoid missteps of leadership. Although making missteps can be a learning opportunity, taking the time to learn how to recognize and avoid common mistakes can help you become productive, successful, and respected by all of your staff. Here are some examples of decisions or actions that can become a problem for you as a leader and your school. Understanding the misstep is the first stage to avoiding it. The role of school administrator is evolving from a building manager into an instructional leader. This shift is not easy, and all leaders strive to be the best they can be. Being a school leader isn't easy, and you're not going to make the right call all the time. However, you can learn and avoid some of these common missteps. First, trying to be too popular. Too often, leaders think they must please everybody, and worse, please them all the time. Yes, you want to be well-liked, but it's more important to be respected. Respect is gained by a leader when he or she is consistent and has clear communication, sets expectation, and clear boundaries, and makes tough and usually necessary decisions. Sometimes those tough decisions are not very popular. I have found that if you keep students at the core and are consistent with your decisions, staff accept unpopular decisions if you communicate the reason why. Not asking your staff, when you can, for their input before the decision is another misstep you want to avoid. Second is not defining your goals. When your staff doesn't know your goals as a leader, they are not efficient educators, and it's difficult to support you as the leader. It is difficult for staff to be productive if they don't know or see what they're working for or what that work means for them in the classroom. Setting your goals as the leader is the roadmap for your success and for the school's growth. Third, assuming you are right instead of working to get it right. Often, leaders mistakenly think that their title in a position means their way is automatically the right way. This comes from not listening to input from other staff members to avoid the perspective and also to engage their ownership and involvement in the decision-making process. The more time a leader spends involving his or her team at the beginning of the process, the easier it will be to carry forth a decision and move towards this established goal that we've already talked about. Fourth, talking the talk and not walking the walk. Leaders must mold their own behavior to reflect what they want from their staff. Successful leaders tend to be positive role models for their staff. A leader must lead by example. If teachers need to stay late, you should also stay late to help them. Or if the culture is that no staff is eating lunch in their classroom, then as a leader, set an example and eat in the staff room, or if that's not comfortable, eat with the students. The same goes for your attitude. If you're negative some of the time, your staff will be negative some of the time too. If you're a positive leader, your team will be positive. If you just tell what to do for others, the same negativity will come through with your staff. Model the traits that you would like to see your staff members display. Next, not providing feedback. A common misstep leaders make is to not offer constructive feedback to the staff. When you don't provide prompt feedback rooted in evidence, you're depriving your staff the opportunity to improve their practice. Not providing feedback also removes and boosts the confidence in what they're told. If they're doing a good job, let them know. Avoid that misstep by providing regular growth-providing feedback focused in the effective manner of common respectful feedback. Another misstep is a failure to delegate. Some school leaders don't delegate because they feel that nobody but them can do the task correctly. This is why it's a common misstep. What quickly follows is stress and burnout. Delegation can take a lot of effort as it can be hard to trust your staff to do the work correctly. But unless you delegate, you're never going to have time to focus on the vision and goals of your school. Leaders have a busy, full schedule, so it makes sense to ask others to handle a variety of tasks. Talking about time, it's a misstep not to make time for your staff. It's easy for us as leaders to get wrapped up in emails and phone calls and data analysis and our own work. But before you know it, you're not available to your staff. People must come first. If you're not available when your staff needs you, the staff will feel that they're not supported and they'll lose trust. However, be careful of open door policies. Make yourself available to your school community, but do it strategically. Block out the times in your daily and weekly calendar to focus on being visible for classroom visits, for students, and your goals. Scheduling times during the week for people to make appointments to see you if they feel needed is important because you have to balance your time for staff, but don't lose focus on the goals of your day. Another misstep is meeting just because. Meeting for the sake of meeting or having regular meetings doesn't support the agenda, especially if you don't have an agenda, and then it really frustrates people. Plan meetings for a strategic purpose or to develop professional learning outcomes, not just to disseminate information. Staff will appreciate this strategy and see you as an understanding leader who understands their need and respects their time. When you do meet, staff will be focused and ready to contribute. There are so many different characteristics and traits of a good leader, but these missteps are ones I think leaders often find themselves stepping into and spending too much time trying to get out. Knowing the pitfalls may help you avoid them. Leadership effectiveness must result in enabling, supporting, and empowering your staff to do everything in their ability to support learning. Avoiding these missteps and jump right into being a leader. So thank you for tuning in. I know my 11 years as being a principal and the last 3 years spent here as a district leader, I've seen some of these, and this is why I wanted to share them with others and share our experience. So continue tuning in to Milford TV, MPS Talks, Superintendent's Updates. There's a lot of great things going on here right in Milford Public Schools.